Say Selenium class 15, Java methods. In this Java methods, today we will discuss user defined methods. Basically, Java methods two types. One is predefined methods, another is user defined methods. Today we will discuss user defined methods, tomorrow predefined methods. First chapter index, first one. Introduction to Java methods. Introduction to Java methods. Next, second one, types of methods. Next, third topic in this chapter, user defined methods. Okay. First I am taking introduction to Java methods. First, what is method? Simple. Java method is a set of statements or steps that are grouped together to perform an operation. See, Java method is a set of statements. Grouped together to perform an operation. Next. Methods are equivalent to functions in structured programming. Not exact equal, some similar. Methods are equivalent to functions in structured programming. Example C. Methods are equivalent to functions in structured programming example C language. Ours is object oriented programming. Next, in structured programming we use functions, predefined and user-defined functions. See, in structured programming, we use functions. Structured programming. Example, C language. We use functions. Functions basically two types, predefined and user defined. Next, in object oriented programming, example Java, we use methods, predefined and user defined. See, In object oriented programming example Java language, we use methods, predefined and user defined. Okay, this is about what is methods. Next, when we choose methods, any idea, Chandra? When we choose methods,
when we need to do any task, we need to perform any.
If we perform any task, then you no need to choose methods. You can directly write the main program. When we choose methods, suppose if you want to do any task, just write main program. Any problem?
Yeah.
No problem. Whenever we want to perform any operation multiple times,
multiple times.
Then we choose methods. This multiple times is important. Suppose whenever we want to perform any operation single time, that time no need to choose methods. You can write main program only.
Main program.
This is sub program. Yeah. Okay. That is the primary purpose. Syed, are you following? Purpose of methods.
Yes, sir.
Whenever we want to perform any operation multiple times, then we choose methods. Whenever we want to perform any operation multiple times, instead of writing the same code again and again, you create method. Wherever required, you can call that method. So you can, yeah. So that you can reduce the code size, you can save the time and efforts also. Okay.
Yes.
Advantage of methods. Code reusability. This is one advantage. Next, code maintenance. Code maintenance is easy. These two are the important advantages. See, this is about methods, a brief introduction about methods. Next, types of methods in Java. Observe Tripura, I think in first chapter, overview of Java programming chapter, we discussed. We have two types of methods. What are they?
Predefined and user defined.
Good. Predefined methods. Methods. Next, built-in methods. Sorry, user defined methods. Tripura, can you tell me what is the difference between predefined methods and built-in methods? Another term is there, built-in methods. Both are same or different?
Different, sir.
Some similar. Predefined means already defined, but yes, built-in means defined and loaded into your program.
Yes, sir.
Defined and loaded. Suppose system.out.println, that is predefined and loaded, means built in. Suppose scanner predefined but not built in.
Yes, sir.
Why all predefined are not built in? See, if they use all predefined features as built-in features, then memory will be reduced. Getting?
Yes, sir.
That's why they included some important features only as built-in. For remaining features, you can import and use. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Just a brief introduction about predefined methods. See, we have several categories of Java methods, predefined methods. We have several categories, but four categories are important. What are they? I will explain. Before that, a brief introduction about predefined methods. Java has a library of classes and methods organized in packages. Suppose java.io, io is package, java.util, util is package. Okay. Java has library as a library of classes and methods organized in packages. Example, import Java dot Java dot IO dot console. See, importing console predefined class from IO package under Java project. Suppose if you want to import all predefined classes from IO package like this, import Java dot IO IO dot asterisk symbol dot star. Then you can import all classes from IO package and you can use available methods in those classes. Don't import unnecessary things. Your memory will be reduced. Okay, na? Next, in order to use predefined libraries, we need to import packages. Some are built-in, some are predefined only. You need to import. Okay? Observe. In order to use predefined libraries, we need to import packages or classes. Entire package or single class. Here one small note, observe Tripura. Some features are built-in. You no need to import. For remaining, you need to import and use. For example, Java dot lang. Lang package is automatically imported in every Java program. Observe this system dot out dot println feature available in Java dot lang package. You no need to import, automatically imported in every Java program.
Okay.
Program. Next, using import keyword, that is Java keyword, using import small letters, using import, don't use double quotes for Java keywords. Here only for understanding point of view, I am writing double quotes. But don't use double quotes for Java keywords and reserved words in your programs. Using import keyword, we can import predefined libraries. Libraries. Come Tripura. Categories. Just a brief idea. Tomorrow we'll discuss predefined methods.
Yes.
Categories. Categories
Street.
Of predefined methods. Predefined methods. See, we have several categories. But our test automation point of view, three or four categories are important that we will discuss. First one, string methods, operations on strings. Our test automation point of view, string is very important. String methods, operations on strings. Next, array methods. Operations on arrays. Next, number methods. Operations on numbers. Next, character methods. Operations on characters. Next, array list methods also there. Several categories are there, but these are the important categories for our test automation. Okay, now Harapreet, are you following?
Yes, sir, I'm following.
You come Harapreet for some time. I think your system is making noise. You try to avoid that one.
Okay,
Tripura, I will call you later. You come Syed Ahmad.
Yes, sir.
Third topic in this chapter, user-defined methods. See, for predefined methods, I have given a brief idea. Tomorrow we will discuss with examples. Today, our focus on user-defined methods. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Again, user-defined methods, two types, based on their usage. Method with written a value. Methods perform operations. Apart from performing operations, also written a value. Getting? Every method perform operation. Method is technical term. Operation is business term. Every method performs an operation. But apart from operation, returning a value, that is extra. Next, second one. Method without returning any value. only performing operation method without return any value. Only performing operation. Next, observe Syed.
Yes, sir.
First one, method with return a value. Again, two types. Calling, two types. Creation, calling. Calling, two types. What are the two types? Suppose A. Calling point of view. Call methods by invoking object. These are called non-static methods. Next, call methods without invoking object. These are called static methods. Okay, in second type also, call methods by invoking object, next without invoking object. Find the difference between these two, Chandra, non-static and static methods. Chandra.
Yes.
What is the primary difference between these two, non-static and static?
I think the method
with we can call non-static methods by invoking object only.
Yes.
Yeah, we need to have object.
Object is required for calling non-static methods. Without object, object means instance of the class. You know how to create the object.
Right.
You know, that we will discuss again. Mm-hmm. Next, static methods. Calling methods without invoking object. Without object.
Sure. No object required.
No object required for calling static methods. Okay. That is the primary difference. Next, two small suggestions. Note. Write or create methods. Write or you can say create methods outside of the main method. Main method is predefined and built-in methods outside of main method. That is a declaration section, main method. But within the class. But within the class, just a minute. Observe Chandra, suppose create a Java class, project, next package, this is the sequence, create new class, suppose. Just a minute. Java methods generate the main method. Observe. This is the class skeleton. Create methods outside of the main method. But within the class, see third line, 10th line, that is class. Third line starting, 10th line closing. Next main method, 5th line open, 8th line close.
Open
and here observe in this area, 4th and 5th lines area, this is outside of the main method, na?
Yeah.
Outside of the main method. Next, 10th line. What about 10th line?
Within the class, that will be.
This is also outside of the main method, na?
Yeah, but within the class.
See, observe. This is outside. Outside of the.
But main outside method. Of the main, but it is within the class, right?
Within the class, yes. Observe, class closing 11th line.
So we could put that in 4th lines also then.
Yes.
The same thing, right?
Yes.
Okay.
This is also outside.
Right.
Observe. This is also outside.
Yeah.
Next. This is first fulfill na. Write or create methods outside of main method but within the class only. Next, second one, call means use. Call methods within the main method. Within the main method. Getting?
Yeah.
Program, Java program execution starts from main method. So call methods within the main method. This is within main method. Within the main method. Okay na? Observe Tripura, any problem?
No sir, got it.
Within main method. Here, call. Call methods. Call methods. Here, create methods. Create methods. Just a minute. This is the basic. Observe Chandra, any confusion?
Oh no. So that means we can only create a method in the class.
In the class, within the class only, not outside of the class.
We cannot create any method in the main, that means, right?
Yes.
And we can call the method in the class level.
Class level only, but other classes also, that is different case.
And I mean for the calling.
Call, there are two within things, the main and method, create. You remember that thing, within the main method. Within the main method means within the class only. But outside of the class also you can call. That is a different case.
Mm-hmm.
You can call outside of the class. Reusability is there, na?
Right, yeah.
By inheritance feature, you can call outside of the class also. But in another class also, within the main method only. That class main method. Getting?
Outside of the main method, create method.
Suppose we have two classes. First class having main method, second class having main method. Main method is mandatory for every class.
Right.
Suppose in first class, we created a method outside of the main method. If you want to call this one, within this main method, you can call. Suppose from another class, in another class, main method is there, na?
Right.
Within that main method only you can call these methods.
Oh yeah.
Getting?
Okay, getting, yeah.
Just a minute. This is class open. Class open. This is main method starts. The seventh one, what is seventh one, Syed?
Yes, sir.
What is seventh one? Main method ends. Next, what is this eighth line? Class close. Getting?
No, sir.
Not this one.
Ninth one, right, sir?
Ah, yes, misplaced. Ah, this one. Ah, any problem, Syed?
No, I don't get this. It's
why you are confusing? Where we declared class in third line, na?
Yes.
Third line is class open, na?
Correct.
Outside of the class also some statements are there. Package, import statements, etc.
Yes.
Package import. Okay, leave them. Class open statement is third statement. That is class open. Class closing. Open. Ninth statement. Curly braces.
Yes. Yes.
Next.
Okay.
Main method open. Fifth line.
Okay.
Next. Class main open. Method close. Seventh okay. line.
Okay.
Any problem?
No. Okay, no, I got it. Okay.
Within the main method only, you can write and execute our program.
Yeah.
Main method. What is the purpose of main method? Program execution starts from main method. Getting?
Yeah. Yes.
Arapreet, confirm Arapreet. Any confusion?
No, sir. It's good. It's clear.
Okay, welcome. What about you, Tripura? Are you following?
Yes, sir. Got it. Thank you.
Welcome. You come, Tripura. Examples. User defined. User defined methods. Examples. You take first one, Tripura. First one. What is our first one? This one.
Call methods.
Method with return a value. In that, call method by invoking object. Means non-static method. First I am creating non-static method. Non-static method in this category. Returning value category. Without returning any value category, also non-static methods are there. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
First, syntax. Syntax. Access modifier. See, you no need to focus on access modifiers. Generally, we use public modifier only in our test automation. Why? Ours is teamwork. We share resources among team members. So 99%, 100% we use public modifier only. But developers may use, Java developers may use other modifiers like private, protected and default due to some security reasons in their development. But in your interview also, you can explain. In my project, we used public access modifier only. We never used other modifiers like access modifier. Next, return type. Here you need to specify the data type. Next, method name. Next, parameters. Or arguments. And one more thing, Tripura, parameters optional. If you don't use any parameters, use blank parentheses. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Blank brackets. Next, method body, statements. Here I am not writing complete syntax. Every normal statement should end with semicolon. Okay, this is method body. Next,
written
statement. Written statement. Next, close curly braces. Curly braces. This is okay. Next, here, observe. Methods take parameters, but parameters are optional. If you don't want to use parameters, then write blank parentheses and use data type for these types of methods. Return type means data type. Okay? Observe this note. Methods take parameters. But parameters are optional, not mandatory. Optional. If you don't want to use any parameters, then write blank parentheses. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Observe. Blank parentheses. This is blank. Blank means no parameters. No parameters. Next, int a comma int b
with parameters.
What about the values for parameters?
We can give values
while calling the method, not now. This is only creating. While calling methods, we can give values, parameters.
That is in main method, right, sir? That is in main method.
Within main method. Suppose you can write string name. Only one also, no problem.
Yes, sir.
Suppose okay, you can use multiple also, int a, int b, int c, and don't mix different types of parameters like int a string b. Like here, return type is int. If method return type is int, then use integer type parameters only. Method return type is string, use string type parameters only. Don't use mixed. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, observe. Next.
Can you please write that point in the note section? Don't you?
Okay, cool. Tell me. Use parameters. Use parameters based on your method return type only. Return type only. don't mix, don't use, just a minute. Don't use different type of different type of parameters. Only single type, that is method return type. Any problem?
Different data type, right, sir?
Return type, don't use different type means different data type.
Yes.
Type means that is default.
Yes, sir.
Any problem?
No, sir, got it.
Next, this is creating methods. Next, calling. Calling methods. That is creating. observe. The syntax. Syntax for creating methods. This type only. Another type syntax may syntax will vary. Calling methods. Calling methods. This is non-static na. Object required first. Okay. First. Create object. Create object. You know how to create object?
Yes. New equal to new.
Class name.
Class name.
Class name. Next. Method name. This is user defined. You can use A, B, C, D or Tripura, no problem. Use.
Yes.
Try to use meaningful names. Standard names. Equals to new keyword. Again, class name, open and close parenthesis, semicolon. Next, this is create. Next, call.
Calling.
Call. How to call? If you want call, to return that value into that one, data type required, na?
Yes, sir.
Data type, same as return type, method return type.
Yes, sir.
Next, variable name. If you want to display, you can directly display, but this is the best practice. Equals to object. Object. Next, dot
object,
object name. Dot method of values. Values for parameters. Suppose if no parameters, use blank parenthesis, semicolon. Okay. This is about calling. Observe the example. Just a minute. Just a minute. I remove this comments. Open curly, close curly brace, close curly brace. Okay. Observe, create, create a non-static method with parameters. Without parameters also you can create, you can practice parameters. Okay. Create a non-static method with return a value and parameters. Getting?
Yes, sir.
Next, access modifier public. Suppose I am going to create integer type method int add one, suppose int num1 comma int num2. Suppose this method is for adding two numbers, any two integer type, any two, wherever required you can call. This is partial syntax, that's why it is showing error. Next, I am taking one local variable. Int result equals to num1, this is parameter, plus num2. Already we defined the data types for parameters. Integer. Observe Syed. Here, what is the method return type? What is the method return type? Chandra, what is the method return type?
It's int.
Integer. What parameters return type? Parameters data type?
This integer, that's why the result will also be the integer.
Yes. And one more thing. For variables, we call data type. For method, we call return type. Don't call method. What is method data type? What is method return type?
Yeah, method is return type.
Return result, semicolon. Okay. I have written a simple method in Selenium test cases chapter. Again, we will use these methods. Next, one more method, observe Tripura. One more method. This time, create a non-static method. Without parameters, return type okay. Without parameters, with return a value, and without parameters. Getting?
Yes, sir.
Observe. Public int, suppose another method, add two blank parentheses. Open curly braces. Suppose int a equals to 10, b equals to 20, c equals to 30. Next, suppose int res equals to a plus b plus c. What is the advantage of using parameters? Can you guess, Tripura? If you use parameters, then you can provide dynamic values while calling the methods now. Respond, Tripura. Any problem?
Yes, sir. Got it, sir.
You respond. Otherwise, my thinking is you are not understanding the concept. What is the advantage of using parameters? If we use parameters, then we can use dynamic values while calling the methods. First time,
yes,
100, 200. Second time, 300, 400.
Yes,
like that. Suppose if
yes,
you don't use parameters, fixed values only.
Yes, sir.
Fixed values only. That is the advantage of using parameters. And one more thing, observe. Here we have two non-static methods with return a value. One is add1, another is add2. Add1 for adding two numbers, any numbers.
Yes.
Next, add2 for adding three numbers, but number fixed values number. Fixed.
Fixed numbers.
Fixed numbers. Fixed numbers. Next, call the methods. You know how to call. Object is required. Object is required. First, yes. Create object.
Class name.
Create object. Object. Class name. What is the class name? Java methods. Java methods. Just a minute. Next, object name. Suppose OBJ. You can use A, B, C, D, R, X, Y, Z also. Next, new. Again, class name. Open and close parenthesis. Semicolon. Object created. How to guess? Suppose OBJ dot. Methods coming na?
Yes, sir. And.
So now it is object. OBJ is object. Yes, now, first call methods. This is create object. Create object. Next.
Calling the method.
Call methods. Call methods. First call add one. Suppose I am taking into local variable int x equals to obj dot add one. Suppose 1, 2, 3, next 2, 3, 4. I can give dynamic numbers. This is the advantage of using parameters. Suppose if you want to pass that value, you can pass 2. Another operations. Otherwise, if you want to print the value, you can print.
Sir, can we give 3 numbers? We cannot give, right?
Integer, yes, it will support 3 numbers.
Okay.
Suppose if you want lengthy number that time, you change the method return type long and parameters data type long.
No, sir. We took only 2 numbers, right, sir, here?
2 numbers.
Can we take like 3?
3, it will take.
It takes
3 took, numbers. Any problem?
No, sir. We took num1 and num2, right, sir?
Yes.
Can we take num1 and num2, num3?
No.
No, okay.
No, that is incorrect. Okay. That is incorrect. Okay. Observe.
It won't accept, right, sir?
Error, na?
Yes, yeah.
Remove argument to match add one int. Remove.
Yes.
Remove that one. Syntax error.
Okay.
Now, no syntax error. See, you cannot take more arguments. Only defined arguments only. Any problem?
No, sir. Got it.
Int y equals to obj dot add to blank parenthesis. Blank parenthesis. SYSO control space enter. Y. This is fixed. 30 plus 30, 60. Run the program. First one 357. Second one 60. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
We are taking into variable and using that value. Suppose if you want to just print the value, then you no need to take into variable. Print the value directly. Suppose obj dot add 1, 2, 3. Don't give more parameters, only declared parameters. Next, SYSO control space enter. obj dot add to, okay. What is the first one output? 35. Second one fixed output?
60.
Run the program. 35, 60. Okay, yes. Na Chandra, are you following? Any confusion?
Yes.
Chandra?
No, that's good.
Any
good.
Problem, Tripura?
No, sir, got it.
Okay.
Got
it. And one more thing. This method declaration, fourth line to 14th line, fourth to 14th, outside of main method. Getting?
Yes, sir.
Next?
Yeah.
But inside the class.
But inside the class. Next, 6th line to 18th line within main method. Next, 19, after 19 also within main, outside of main method only. Getting?
Yes, sir. Within the class.
Within the class. Observe, class closing, 31st line. Run the program, it will execute. Observe. Yes. Chandra, before main method or after main method, but within the class, outside of the main method, but within the class, that is important.
Right.
Harapreet, are you following or any confusion? Harapreet.
Sir, it's good. I'm following.
Welcome. You come, Syed. Syed.
Yes, sir.
Take second one, Syed. What is the second one? This time, static method. First one, B. 1B. 1A over. 1A yes. over. 1B. This time, without invoking any object. Without invoking any object. Observe the syntax. Syntax for creating methods. Okay. Access modifier. Next, static keyword, fixed one. This is non-access modifier. Next, return type. Method return type. Next, for a method name. Next, parameters. Okay, open curly braces. Next, this is called method body. Next, close parenthesis. Before that, return statement. Okay. For calling methods. Methods. Suppose data type, no object required. See, calling static methods, no object required. Data type, variable name, equals to, observe Tripura, equals to class name already there, class name dot method name, just a minute, method name of values for parameters, parameters, okay na, semicolon, semicolon. Suppose you are calling the static method within the same class, that time class name also optional, class name also optional. Observe Chandra, class name also optional. Suppose you are calling okay. from other class, that time required, but use class name, that is best practice.
Mm-hmm.
Just a minute. Just method name. Okay, na?
Yeah.
Any confusion?
No, that's good.
Okay, cool. This is about syntax. Next, example. Example. Observe. Suppose remove all this content. Syed Ahmad.
Yes, sir.
Create a static method with return a value and parameters. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Create a static method with return a value. What is the advantage of non-static? That we will discuss in inheritance chapter. Create a static method with return a value and parameters. Parameters. Okay? Create same like add method, or suppose this time multiply one. Create public static, next return type int method name multiply, suppose multiply one. Okay, next int a int b, open curly braces. Next why it is showing syntax error? Incomplete syntax. We need to complete this one. After okay. completion of this method body, it will remove. Okay?
Okay.
Next, okay. int result equals to a b. A into b. Next, return result. Okay, na? Next, create a static method with return a value, with return a value and no parameters. Create, suppose public static method name, data types, return type int, suppose multiply two. blank parenthesis. Okay, suppose int x equals to 10, comma int y equals to 30.
Tenth line at the end.
Sorry. Open curly braces. Open curly braces. Oh, why it is showing? Again, int not required. Again, int not required. Next, return. Return. You can directly perform operation here. XY. It is not taking multiply 2 XY. Just a minute. Close parenthesis. Okay. Incomplete syntax. Okay, na? Observe Tripura. Next, call methods. Call non-static methods. Guide me, Syed Ahmad. Guide me.
Non-static.
First, call multiply, then call multiply one. Then call multiply 2.
Sir, we are doing static methods, right?
Yes. Sorry. Call static methods. Yes. Good observation. Yeah. You know, no object required. Using class name, you can call. Otherwise, you can call directly. Suppose.
Access modifier start.
Res 1 equals to. Java methods. It is class name available. You don't need to create dot multiply one. Suppose 1, 2. Just a minute. 3, 4. Semicolon. Next, SYSO, control space enter, res one, I think 46, run the program, 408, multiply, okay, it is multiply. 408, correct. Next, observe Chandra. Print directly without taking into variable. Print directly this multiply 1. Before that, I will show this one. Without class. Observe. Res 1 already there, na? Already declared. Res 1 equals to method name. Multiply 1 of 2 comma 4. Semicolon. Now observe 20th line Chandra. Without using class name, we are directly calling. Any problem?
No.
But try to use class name. Suppose if it is same class, no problem. If it is another class, use the class name syntax. Class name syntax. 8. run the program. 8. Next, if you want to print directly, SYSO control space enter, Java methods dot multiply 1, suppose 1, 4 or 3, 4, output 12. Next, without class name, SYSO control space enter, suppose multiply 1 of 4, 5, output 20. Observe last two outputs, 12 and 20. Run the program. Observe Chandra, last two outputs, 12 and 20, na?
Yeah.
Next.
Those two last two are without using the class name, right?
No. Class name I used now, without taking into variable.
Displaying directly.
But taking into variable, take the value, method return value into variable and display or pass the value to any other operation, that is best practice.
Yeah.
Which one is best practice? Direct display or taking into variable?
Taking into variable.
Variable. If you take into variable, then you can use the value anywhere in the program. If you display, just a display. Observe these four flavors. Okay, na? Observe. Taking into variable using class name. Next, so, taking into variable without class name.
So, can you please put on comment over there so that it will be easy for to remember.
What is the comment?
No. That means displaying directly without using the variables.
Ah, yes.
Or like that one.
Assign to variable. Assign to variable that assign to variable. What is assigning? A method returning value.
Method returning value. Yeah.
Method returning value. Method, just a minute, returning value assigned to a variable. Getting?
Yeah.
Variable. Next, this scenario. Rest one, okay. This scenario. Display the method return value
without taking variable.
Return value, just a minute. Method return value directly means no storage, no assignment. Okay.
Yeah.
Any problem?
No, that's good.
Okay. Run the program. Okay. Observe Harapreet. Facing any problem?
No, sir, it's good.
Okay, welcome. For next example, come Chandra. Second one. What is second one? Without returning any value. Just a minute. See, by practicing all these examples, definitely you can get more clarity.
Clarity, right, that's true.
Just a minute. Second one. What is second one? Method with return, without return any value, but call methods by invoking object. Non-static only. What is the difference between previous non-static and this non-static? Previous non-static return a value, but this non-static without return any value. But both are required object for calling. Getting?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Syntax for create. Creating methods. Access modifier. Next, Java keyword, return nothing. Return nothing. For this return nothing, returns nothing, we use void keyword, void. Return nothing. Next, method name. Next, parameters. Open curly braces. Next, method body. Next, close curly braces. No return type. Next, calling methods. You know, create object is mandatory. Example. Just observe. Skeleton. Create a method. Create a non-static method and returns nothing. Here I am showing simple examples. Single example. You can practice with multiple examples. Create a non-static method. Create a non-static method and returns nothing. Observe Tripura. Public void method name. Suppose comparison blank parenthesis. You can use parameters also. Next, int a equals to 100. Next, b equals to 50, semicolon. Next, within methods you can use conditional statements and loop statements also. All features can be used within methods also. If a greater than b, A greater than B. Next, SYSO control space enter. A is a big number. It is print statement. Returning value is different. Returning value means passing value. It is just displaying.
Yes, sir.
Suppose in your method no display statement, so then no display. A is a big number. Only understanding purpose I am writing display statement. Display statement is not mandatory.
Okay.
Else, SYSO control space enter. B is a big number. B is a big number. Okay. Close method. Okay. Next, create object. Otherwise, you can use parameters. If you use parameters, how to use? Suppose int A, comma int B. Remove these two. Int A, int B. Observe.
It won't work, right, sir?
It is taking. No syntax error. We will check it. Int B. Parameters. Next. Chandra, create object or instance of the class.
Yeah. Class name.
Create object. Create object. Class name. Java methods obj, or you can use any name abc. Yeah. Equals to new Java
methods.
New Java methods. Open and close parenthesis. Semicolon. Next. Call the methods. Create object. Okay. Call the methods. Methods without returning any value, na?
Yeah.
So you no need to take variable. Just pass. ABC dot comparison, suppose 150. Run the program. Observe, A is a big number. Suppose A 100, B 500. This time B is a big number based on the arguments. Okay, na?
Yes.
Suppose you try this one. Suppose car B. It is taking no syntax error. Observe Tripura, no syntax error. Now, if you use different data types in
yes.
these methods, I think runtime. No. Why it is showing A is a big number?
Maybe ASCII even. It takes ASCII.
ASCII 65 only, na? Say,
yeah, 60.
Blindly okay. It is going to else part.
Okay.
Blindly it going to. Actually, it is not correct operation. It is not correct operation. It is not showing any syntax error or runtime error, but it is not correct operation. To 200, otherwise 20. A is a big number. A is a big number. Okay, here no variable required. Why? Return type nothing.
Okay.
Return type nothing. Just a minute. Class. Okay. Next, last one. Last one. Observe Harpreet. You come, Harpreet. Last one. Four, 2B. 2B. Two B. What is 2B? Call methods without invoking object. Static methods. This time static methods. Okay. Syntax. Syntax. For static method, no object required. And no return type in this scenario. Access modifier, next, static keyword, static, it is, just a minute, static keyword means non-access modifier, next, void means returns nothing, next, method name, next, parameters optional, na? Optional, open curly braces, next, method body, close parenthesis, okay, just a minute. Call. Okay. Example. Observe Harpreet. Observe. This time, create a static method and returns nothing.
Would
create a static method and returns nothing. Okay. Harpreet.
Yes, sir.
Comparison method, right? Public, static, void. Next, method name.
Comparison.
Use arguments or without using arguments also you can write. Suppose use arguments. Suppose int A, comma, Int B. Open curly braces, next, write condition, direct condition. If A greater than B, If A greater than B, open curly braces. Do something. System dot out dot println of A is a big number. A is a big number. Else, open curly brace, curly braces. B is a big number. B is a big number. Okay. Next, no object required. Call this method, Harapreet. Call this method. No object is
we'll start with comparison.
Otherwise use class name.
Class name Java methods dot comparison. Practice,
but without class name also you can call dot comparison.
Comparison.
Suppose 1, 2, 3, 4. It will show B is a big number. B is a big number. Okay. Next, without without class name also you can call comparison of 100, 50 semicolon. Observe first output B is a big number. B is a big number according to these values. Second one, A is a big number. A is a big number. Run the program. B is a big number. A is a big number. Okay, now Syed, any problem?
Sir, I need to practice a lot.
Practice.
Yes.
Just a minute. I have introduced all flavors. You practice in Selenium test cases. We use methods for code reusability. Code reusability. Next, call. This is internal use. Say usage. Usage of methods. Observe Tripura, you come Tripura. First one, usage of methods. First one,
code reusability.
Internal use. All are code reusability only. First one, internal use.
Inside the class.
Second one, external use. What is internal use? Create and call methods within the same class. Good. Getting?
Yes, sir.
Within the same class. Suppose we have one class. Class 1. Create method in class 1 and call in the same class 1. That is internal use. Next. Here calling. Calling methods from another class. This is external use. Another class. Suppose create methods in class 1 and call these methods from class 2. That is external use. Getting?
Yes, sir.
I think all of you familiar with internal use. Next, observe the external use. Observe the external use. Observe Tripura. Observe. Create one class. Suppose new class. Class name. Class 1. Generate the main method. Finish. Okay. Next here. Create one non-static method. Non-static method with returning value or without returning value. Create a non-static method with return value or without returning any value. Observe public suppose returning value public int add suppose parameters optional int a int b semicolon sorry open curly braces okay next suppose int result equals to a plus b data type already defined next return result. Semicolon next call this method within the class. This is internal use, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
First, create object. You know how to create object.
Yes.
Create object. Suppose class name.
Class one. Object.
Equals to.
New class one,
open and close parenthesis, semicolon. Next, call that method, return type is there now. You take into variable, same data type. Suppose int res equals to object obj dot add. Add 1, 2, 3. Next, just a minute. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Semicolon. Run the program. Why it is not written? We didn't display, na?
Yes.
Display statement required. Res. Run the program. Okay, na?
Yes. Yes, sir.
579. This is internal use.
Yes.
Just a minute. Internal. Calling or internal use. Internal use of a method. Method. This is internal use. Next, external use. use of a method, external use of a method. Observe, suppose here I just created, next create one more class, select package, right click, new class, suppose
class 2,
generate the main method, finish. Okay.
Yes.
Suppose without inheriting means reusing, without inheriting the classes, just call. You can call. Why? These both classes are in same package, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Same ABCD package. So you can call. Just a minute.
And it is also public, so we can
call a method from another class, within the same package. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Within the same package. Here first create object, na, that is non-static, na, create object. How to create object?
Class 2.
You have to create object using parent class name.
Oh,
why? Okay. We are not inheriting classes. If you inherit classes, then you can create object using class 2 name. Getting this point?
Okay, sir.
Suppose without inheritance, then use parent class name. Observe, what about child class name? Suppose class 2 OBJ equals to new. You can create object, but calling problem. Semicolon. Object created, na?
Yes, sir.
Next, call that one. OBJ dot. Know that add method, na?
Yeah, it's not showing.
Not showing that method. These are already predefined. Not showing. Suppose use class 1. Use parent class name for creating object. Then you can access parent class members.
Yes.
OBJ dot add, suppose 1, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3. Semicolon. This method returns value, na? Returns value. Suppose int x equals to. Next.
System dot.
SYSO control space enter. X. Then you can get 36, na?
36.
Run the program. 36. Getting? This is external,
yes,
use, na?
Yes, sir.
This is external use. Class members means variables and methods. Suppose int I equals to 100. Int I equals to 100. Suppose SYSO control space enter OBJ dot I.
Sir, here class 2 is public, right, sir?
Class
if 2? It is public, right, sir? Public.
Class 2 is public. Yeah. Class 1 also public, na?
Yeah, if it is, let's take private, we cannot access it, right,
yes,
sir?
Yes, private problem. That's why I told, in our test automation, most of the time we use public only.
What about protected?
You no need to learn that one. We never use.
Okay.
Why you protect? You have to share your resources to all team members. So no protected. In interviews also you can explain. We never use it protected and default. Not required.
Okay.
You don't focus on that one. That is development activities.
Okay.
Observe. You are asking class members also, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I available in class 1.
Yes, sir.
Class 1. Okay. Here you are accessing.
Yes, sir.
Observe, class Chandra. Two. Any problem, Chandra?
Yeah. No, it's good.
What is the I value? 100. 100. Suppose she told na private, remove invalid modifier. Why? Illegal modifier of the class 1 only.
Maybe we are putting private, that's why it's not taking.
Illegal modifier for class 1. Only public, abstract and final are permitted.
Public.
Private, not private is not permitting.
Yeah, that's
yes, sir. Reason. I think we are using class 1 in class 1 in class 2, right, sir? That's why it's not taking.
Just a minute. Default it is accepting. Private. Just a minute. Source add block comment. This time also not accepting. Private modifier is not accepting.
Okay, sir.
Only default modifier. This is default.
Default is accepting.
Yeah.
Next. Protected. Protected also not accepting. Public and default. For classes. Accepting. You practice that one. Check.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Welcome. Public class 2. Okay. Just a minute. Source or remove block comments. Observe, in class 1 we have a variable and one method. These are called as class members. Next, I am calling these class members from another class, external usage, external use. Just a minute. This is class 1. Example, class 1. Next, class 2. Class 2, just a minute. Class 2. Class 2. Observe, Syed.
Yes, sir.
Accessing class members from one class to another within the same package. If it is another package, we need to import that package within the same package. Within the same package. How to access? Create object using parent class name. then you can access class members from from the parent class. Okay, na Chandra, any problem?
That's good, yeah.
Suppose if it is static class member, this is non-static class member. Static, what will happen? Observe Tripura. Suppose public static int, public static int. No need to create object. Here, how to access? Call a static method. Static method from another class in the same package. Tell me. Class name required, na?
Yes.
Suppose here, observe, internal use observe. Suppose, just displaying, you can return to any, you can assign to variable also. What is the class name?
Class one
dot add next parameters 1, 2, 3, 4. Class one dot add 46. Good. Run the program. 46. Okay. Without class name also you can call. Without class name. SYSO control space enter. Just the add of 10, 20. Why? We are in the same class. Run the program. 4630. Next, external use. Suppose
system dot out dot println class one dot,
just a minute, add 10, 20. Error, na?
Yes, sir.
Why? We are in another class. Here class, yes, name required, na?
Yes, sir.
Class one dot. Now it is okay. Just a minute. Now observe Chandra. Writing class name is best practice, na?
Yes, yeah.
But if you are in same class, without class name also you can call. But if you are in another class, class name mandatory.
Yeah.
Parent class name. Tatina.
Yes.
Yes. Just a minute. Anyhow, it is without inheritance. With inheritance, you can use child class name also for creating and accessing object. Suppose without inheritance, use parent class only. With inheritance, use child class. Or you can use parent class also. Anyhow, that we will discuss in inheritance chapter. Just a minute. This is class 2. Just a minute. Class 2. This is class 1. Class 1. Okay, now, Tripura, any confusion?
Yes, sir.
Today we discussed creating and using or calling, creating and calling user defined methods. First, we discussed different types of methods, static, non-static, with written value, without written value, with parameters, without parameters, different flavors of methods. Then, usage also, internal use and external use. Okay, I think I covered maximum concepts regarding user defined methods. Syed, you practice. Okay.
Yes, sir.
If you have any queries, then mail me. Okay.
Okay, sir.
I'm going to close the today's session. Confirm Chandra, any queries?
No, sir, I'm good. Thank you.
Welcome. Harapreet, any queries regarding this today's session?
Yes, sir. Just one point. Like the examples which we discussed were of the we have created classes within the same package.
Yes. In inheritance and chapter, chapter, we will use different packages and different projects also.
Okay, sir. Okay.
It is not time to discuss that concept. Why? If you want to reuse class members from different packages and different projects, inheritance feature is required. Here we are using, we are calling methods without inheritance, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Any other?
All good. No, sir. All good. Thank you.
Welcome. Jayaprakash. I think Jayaprakash joined late. You watch the recorded session and practice the class notes. If you have any queries, then mail me. Okay?
Sure.
Syed Ahmad.
Sir, I'll go through the video again.
Okay, tomorrow. Welcome. Tripura.
Yes, sir, it's clear.
Okay.
Thank you.
Welcome. We will meet tomorrow, same time. Thank you.